Hello to all. In my previous lecture, I completed and differentiate how an impure compound can be differentiated from a pure compound. What is the meaning of impurity? How we can define purity? And whether or not absolute purity can be achieved. I have also discussed and classified impurity into its respective classes or category, and elaborate each class in detail, or each category of impurity in detail. Now the objective of today's lecture is to know what are the various sources of impurities, or how and from where the impurity or the impurity gets incorporated into the pharmaceutical substance or product. Now, as I discussed earlier, that impurity is nothing but only the undesired product or material present in the desired compound. Or drug product. So any foreign material or any undesired chemical substances, if present with the product of interest, substance of interest, or with any pure compound, that foreign material or foreign substance is regarded as impurity. Now, on the basis of the extent that impurity is present in the desired compound or product or in any pharmaceutical substance, it have then have their own consecutive effects. For an example, an impurity can cause change in the physicochemical property of pure substance. An impurity can cause simultaneous side reactions . An impurity can manipulate the pharmacological effect of a drug substance. So in many ways, an impurity affects or influence the basic physicochemical property as well as the desired pharmacological action. Of a drug. So here we will, or in this lecture we will know how the impurity are get incorporated in the drug substance, that is from where or what are the source of that impurity are so here I categorize the various sources of impurity under different heading, and wherever applicable, under different subheadings also. So, turn by turn or in a sequential manner, we will know what are the various sources of impurity are there. The very first source which I mentioned here is the raw material. Raw material means the material in its crude form used for the production of desired chemical or pharmaceutical. The raw material must be processed appropriately before piping it to a synthetic or manufacturing pathway. The second source of impurity which I mentioned here is the process or the method which is involved for the production or manufacturing of pharmaceutical substances or any chemical compound. The next or in this process or method involved for manufacturing of pharmaceutical substance or product is further subcategorized as the impurity from or incorporation of impurity from starting material or from reagent used for synthesis or for purification, then various equipments used during the manufacturing or synthetic procedure, leftover byproduct defect in the manufacturing process or in synthesis. So all these points are subcategorized under the heading process or method involved in the manufacturing process, which if not handled properly is then act as source of impurity or causes the final product to get impure. The next one is storage. Storage means how we stored our processed and non-processed chemical or pharmaceutical substance so that it can be further used as per the desired production or for commercial process. Under storage, we have to, or we will look into what are the conditions required for the storage of pharmaceutical substances or chemical. What are the different property of a container, or how container can act as a source of impurity, and what is the effect of various environmental factors such as heat, light, humidity and other as a source of impurity. So 10 by 10 we will also look into all these factors, how under storage these sub factor can cause impurity in the final product. Then the next include the packing or packaging of the finished product for further transportation and commercial usage. Then we will know how human error will contribute for impurity, and how this deliberate adulteration, which is very dangerous, can cause impurity in the final product. So in sequential manner, we will know how these headings as mentioned here can act as the source of impurities. Now the very first one is the raw material. Now, as the name indicates, the raw material means the crude chemical or the substance which are used for the purpose of manufacturing or yielding the desired product. So before this raw material is used for the manufacturing or use for the process of yielding the desired substance, it has to undergo or it has to investigate it properly for the identification of or identification of or the net content of desired substance or desired product, as well as also investigated for the presence of auxiliary substances with the desired product or the desired compound simultaneously. If the raw material is not pre-processed or is not analytically justify for further manufacturing process or whatever the auxiliary chemicals are present in the raw material are not removed properly, they will get incorporated into the final product, and hence act as a source of impurity. So whatever the raw material is used, for yielding of desired chemical substance or a pharmaceutical product, the raw material should be pre-processed and analytically judge for the net content of impure substance, and should be processed in a suitable manner so that any impurity, if present in the raw material, can be removed before it can incorporated in the final product. Now the processing of raw material is not an easy task, especially if the raw material is derived directly from plant resources. Processing of such raw material obtained from the plant resources is a very tedious task, and it's required a huge amount of time and money both. So if the raw material is impure, or if the raw material is contains impurity beyond the limit, or if the raw material is not pre-processed properly, there are chances that impurity can be incorporated from raw material to the final product, which can be a chemical substance or which can be a pharmaceutical product. Now, impurity can also be incorporated from any process or method involved for the manufacturing or formulation of any chemical substance or drug product. Now, how the process or the method can act as an impurity, or how a particular manufacturing process can act as an impurity, this can be known, or it can be discussed under the following subheadings. As any method or process involves, or any method or process for manufacturing or formulation involves following, such as starting material, reagent, equipments, byproduct, or how it is handled, these all can act as an impurity if not properly handled in a final product. For example, if we will, whatever the starting material is used for the synthesis, if the quantity of starting material is not appropriate as per the process or as per the reaction, the leftover starting material can act as a source of impurity. So inappropriate quantity of starting material in a synthetic path or during formulation can act as a source of impurity. Likewise, whatever the reagents used for the manufacturing of desired product, manufacturing of desired pharmaceutical, is used in an improper manner, or use of inappropriate reagent for a particular set of reaction conditions can act as an impurity. So, for synthetic purpose, the reagent can also be act as a reactant in the synthesis or in a synthetic procedure, or the reagents can be act for purification of final product. So in both the cases, whether the reagent is used either for synthesis or the reagent is used for purification of final product, if is not removed properly or if it is get left over, it can act as a impurity. Now the reagent is a necessary evil. I have only discussed the reagent under the synthetic and purification subheadings. Although in a particular reaction or even in the formulation process, the reagents play vast role. So for whatever or whatsoever the purpose the reagent is used, either in the manufacturing process or for formulating a dosage form or for the purpose of synthesizing a particular chemical or drug substance, or either it is used for the purification, whatever its use is, in the manufacturing process, it must be handled suitably and should not get incorporated into the final product. Though it is necessary for the, or although it is necessary or essential for a particular set of reaction, then also it should not get incorporated, or the reagent should not be present in the final chemical, and if it is present, it itself acts as an impurity, because the reagent is desired for the manufacturing process. The reagent is desired for a particular procedure or for a particular synthetic protocol. It is not desired in the particular product what we are making. So the reagent, if present with a desired product, drug product or a chemical, is itself act as an impurity. So the reagent must be handled properly, and the leftover reagent must be removed by adopting the suitable processes. Now, equipments can also act as a source of impurity. Now, there are number of equipments are used in synthesis or formulation of pharmaceutical substances or product. For example, we are using mixers, dryer, evaporators, there are a number of equipments which are used industrially. As I have said earlier, that we are using mixers, blenders, then evaporators, reactors, etc. An impurity, they can itself be act as a source of impurity in the final product. Either by transferring the metal contents or by leaching of container linings, or either by or from rubber closings, and also by inappropriate cleaning. So from all these ways, the equipment can act as an impurity or source of impurity. So generally, most of the industrial equipments which are now being used are made up of material which can withstand low, that is sub-zero, or from sub-zero to higher temperature under the for a particular reaction condition or for a desired manufacturing process. And most of them are made up of stainless steel, which itself is inert in nature. Proper cleaning of or proper cleaning validation of equipment, especially the industrial equipment, is very necessary. Because odd cleaning can lead to cross-contamination batch to batch. So this is how the equipment can be used or can be act as a source of impurity. Now the byproduct, if produced in a synthetic pathway, if left over, can also be act as an impurity. So before further processing of any chemical substance, or if there is multi-step reaction is there for yielding of or for manufacturing of any drug substance, the byproducts should be removed simultaneously in each step, because if the byproduct is not removed simultaneously and the products so obtained is further introduced or is further inducted for further chemical reaction, there are chances that the byproduct may cause deliberate side reaction which anyhow hamper the genuine purity of final product. Now most of the pharmaceutical companies are focusing how the net yield of byproduct can be reduced as this reduction of yielding of byproduct can increase the production of pure final product as well as reduce the cost of purification. So ideally, if any reaction which is free of byproduct is said to be 100% efficient, because we are getting what we desired. So defect in manufacturing process . So, if a defective manufacturing process or a defective synthetic route is followed, this will lead to the product which is always in an impure form. This is due to the fact that whatever the synthetic pathway which is adopted is unable to utilize the reagent which we are used for the manufacturing of particular chemical or pharmaceutical substance, or drug product. So after a defect in manufacturing process, I have included one more point as solvent as a source of impurity. So solvent is the liquid medium, or solvent is the liquid matrix which is primarily used to dissolve either the starting material, or it is used to dissolve reagent, or it is used for the preparation of reagent, or it is used for or in synthetic reaction purposefully, or for the purpose of purification, etc. can cause impurity if it is not properly removed. Most of the time, or many synthetic as well as formulative tasks in the pharmaceutical industry makes use of organic solvents. And these organic solvents, as they are also chemical compounds, if not be removed properly, or if they are present with the main product or the chemicals which is produced, act as an impurity. So it is necessary to remove the solvent whatsoever is used in the manufacturing or the formulative or the synthetic process so involved for yielding the desired product. Now storage is very important for the processed product. How the processed product is stored, or whether or not it gets favorable condition for storage, or under drastic condition or unfavorable environment of storage, can itself cause impurity in the main product. Now the storage is critical. As if the final product is not stored properly after processing or after manufacturing or after formulating, or if the storage is inadequate, then all the inputs which are used since from yielding of or since from starting or since from manufacturing of final product up to its manufacturing get waste. So storage or condition for the storage for different chemicals or for different drug product is different. For example, we can't store or it is not recommended to store the highly oxidative compound in direct contact with oxygen or in presence of strong light. A highly volatile substance should be stored away from heat as well as light. Explosive chemicals must be stored away from the source of fire, extensive heat, etc. Chemicals which are prone to absorb moisture must be stored away from the or must be stored under dry condition or away from any direct contact with water, moisture or air. So depending what is ultimately or what is the final nature of our product is, we have to select the storage condition and the type of container. For example, as I have discussed, that hygroscopic substance must be stored away from moisture or water or air, and hence the container whatever is selected should not allow the passage of air and moisture. That means it should be stored in an airtight container. Highly oxidative products or the products which are get deteriorated in presence of light must be stored in a dark color bottle or the amber color bottle. For example, the substance which are degraded at high temperature must be stored at suitable cool or cold condition. Any pharmaceutical or any chemicals which are which have low melting point, should be stored in a cold condition. So likewise, what is the final property of the final product is, we have to select the condition and the container for storage. So if storage is inadequate or improper, storage is not good, it is improper, this can cause impurity in the final product. Because if the final product is get exposed under the inadequate storage condition to the reaction initiator such as heat or light, they may bring or they may cause deterioration of the final product or simultaneous side reactions. So it is essential that final product should have good storage condition, or it should be stored in a proper manner. Now packing. So the packing is required for providing an extra coating or providing or to separate or to isolate the product from physical environment or to avoid the exposure of final product to external environment. So for better packing, again, the physicochemical property of that particular compound must be suitably judged. And according to its need or according to the need of storage condition, the packing should be done. Inappropriate packing of any pharmaceutical or any chemical can ultimately causes its deterioration. And how this improper packing causes impurity, we can look it by the some examples. For example, if we have to pack any gaseous chemical or any gaseous pharmaceutical substance, we have to select an appropriate condition and a container during the packing. For example, the volatile gases should be packed at a suitable low temperature, and a container which are totally sealed. Likewise, the pharmaceuticals or chemicals which are prone for oxidation must be packed in a container which inhibit or do not allow the passage of light or air into it. Any drug substance or chemical which is hygroscopic must be packed in an airtight container. And same as in case of storage, if we are unable to provide suitable packing, to the pharmaceutical substance, this will cause deterioration of final product. Because the inappropriate packing can lead or can cause the leakage of final product from its container. It may cause the final product to come in direct contact with the initiators, such as heat and light, or it may cause the final product to be get cross-contaminated. So appropriate packing should be adopted, and likewise on the basis of physicochemical nature of the final product and its physical form, whether the final product is solid, semi-solid, liquid or gas, a proper packaging or proper packing should be selected. Now, human error. So each and every industry as well as laboratory also have guideline how we can reduce the human error, or how the human error can be minimized. Although only formulating a guideline or a protocol do not guarantee that the process so adopted is free from errors. Rather, the analyst or chemist which is working should not only follow those laid down guideline, but he or she must be familiar with the task they are performing. Because everything can't be elaborated. There are minute or there are some conceptual practical tasks are there which one must know before adopting any procedure. So, for the purpose of impurity, how the human error can cause impurity, this can either be done, or human error can be a consequence or can causes the impurity either by wrong selection of method for manufacturing or synthetic procedures, defective selection of chemicals or inappropriate selection of reagents, incorrect handling of final product or the raw material, incorrect handling of manufacturing instruments or analytical instruments, inappropriate or wrong weighing. So all these are included as a human error. Now I have also denoted a term here, deliberate adulteration. Now deliberate adulteration can also cause impurity, and it is not only an important source, but it is also dangerous also. The deliberate adulteration means here everything is final. Means whatever the raw, whatever the product we have synthesized, or whatever the product industry or a lab has synthesized is okay, is fine, no doubt. It's very correct. It is up to the standard. And everything is fine. We are done with all the analytical datas, final analytical datas, and everything is good. But once the final product is out of lab, or once the final product is out for distribution or for commercialization, some low quality or inferior products or chemicals imitating or looking as the same as the final product are get mixed up with a pure product and then further used for the commercialization. So this deliberate adulteration is very dangerous. And each and every government has made a very strict rules and regulation to avoid this deliberate adulteration. And there are strict punishments also if anyone is found to be get involved in adulteration of any, especially for adulteration of any pharmaceutical products or edible items. So this is how all this factor or the source contributes towards impurity in the final product.